Weight is something that matters to almost all of us. So where on earth are we going to weigh less? Let's begin with the basics.
We all have different definitions of weight, but physically, weight is defined as the force exerted on a body due to gravity. Numerically, it is the product of mass and acceleration due to gravity. Weight is a vector quantity, that is, it has both magnitude and direction. It is by definition a force, and like any other force, it has the same unit, Newton. So much for the old charm. We often use the word mass and weight interchangeably, but that's wrong. It would be same as comparing noodles with spaghetti or pasta with macaroni. But we know that they are very different from each other. So what is the difference between mass and weight? Well, the first and the foremost difference is that mass, it's a base quantity. It's a fundamental physical quantity that is not derived from any other quantity. Whereas weight, it's a force and hence is a derived quantity. Mass remains same for a given object. Of course, unless you chop off your hand or cut off your leg. Whereas weight, it changes with the change in acceleration due to gravity. Mass is measured with the help of pan balance and other scales. Whereas weight, it's measured with the help of spring balance. Mass, it's a scalar quantity. Weight, it's a vector quantity. As I told you before, weight is equal to mass into acceleration due to gravity. This implies that weight is directly proportional to mass. But since mass for a particular object remains same over time, therefore, weight largely depends upon acceleration due to gravity, that is g, and is directly proportional to it. When g is more, weight is more. When g is less, weight is less. So if we just find out how acceleration due to gravity varies on Earth, we would be able to find out how weight changes, or increases or decreases, right?
Consider an eyeless and legless you with mass M and the massive Earth with mass capital M. Let distance between you and Earth be D. Then the Earth pulls you with the force Fg towards it, and so do you. Now this force is proportional to the product of masses of bodies, in this case you and Earth, divided by the square of distance between them. Removing the sign of proportionality, we get capital G, or the gravitational constant. But since Fg is a force acting on you, it should be equal to the product of your mass and acceleration you are undergoing. Solving the equation further, we get that acceleration is equal to gravitational constant into capital M upon d square. Now since this acceleration is because of gravity, we get acceleration due to gravity is equal to capital G into capital M upon d square. That's the equation.
Acceleration due to gravity would depend on gravitational constant, mass and distance. But since capital G is a constant, hence its value would always remain same. And so would the value of mass, as said before. Therefore, acceleration due to gravity would depend largely on distance and is inversely proportional to d square. So closer we are to Earth, we get more g, and as we move away, g decreases until it becomes zero, showing the end of Earth's sphere of influence.
So acceleration due to gravity should decrease with an increase in distance from the center of the Earth. So this ends up implying that with an increase in altitude, your weight should decrease.
Consider two scenarios. In the first scenario, you are on the ground near sea level, and in the second scenario, you are on top of a mountain. Then in the first case, your weight is mg, and in the second case, your weight would be mg dash. Since mountain is on a higher altitude, g dash would be less than g, making your weight on mountain less than on ground. But this is change in weight, not mass. Of course, mass changes if instead of using a cable car to reach the top, you decide to walk all the way up there. Say now that we are d distance deep in the Earth. So if the radius of the Earth is r, therefore our new radius should be r minus d. Since r minus d is less than r, therefore acceleration due to gravity should increase, and therefore our weight should also increase. Whereas all this seems right, it's actually wrong. The reason is we end up forming a part of new sphere that has a new mass, m dash. And since m dash is less than m, that is mass of the Earth, and the change in mass is by a greater factor than change in radius, therefore our weight inside the Earth decreases. The Mother Earth, it's not a perfect sphere. It is flat at the poles, and being flat at the poles, the radius at the pole is much less than the radius at the equator, due to which the acceleration due to gravity on the poles is higher. this makes your weight on poles larger, slightly larger than your weight on equator. Or in other words, we can say that you weigh slightly less on equator than on poles.
With the discussion of previous situations, we have notched down most of those places in this blue sphere where you might weigh less. I mean, almost most of them. If I've missed some, please write them down in the comments. But do we limit ourselves there? I mean, and I don't know any limits. So there might be many other places or situation in which your weight might turn out to be less.
So before we proceed with some other situations where you might weigh less, we need to know about pseudo force.
Consider a pendulum of mass m hanging from a bus which is stationary or moving with constant speed. Now after some time the bus starts accelerating. Then a force equal to ma naught starts acting on the pendulum in the opposite direction of acceleration, which pushes it behind by an angle theta. This force is called pseudo force.
So pseudo force is a fictitious force or an apparent force which acts on all bodies that have mass and whose motion is described using a non-inertial frame. By non-inertial, we mean a frame which is accelerating with respect to an inertial frame. For example, in the previous situation, the bus, it formed the non-inertial frame because it was accelerating with an acceleration A0 with respect to the ground. Hence, the pseudo force MA0 started acting on the pendulum which sent it moving backwards, making an angle theta with the vertical.
Take the last situation. You are in a lift and your mass is m. Your weight mg acts in the downward direction. Now if the lift starts moving with acceleration a0, the pseudo force ma0 acts in the opposite direction of your weight. And since we know that weight is force, therefore by simple laws of vector addition, we find that the net force acting on you is less than your actual weight. That is why in a lift coming down, you
weigh less. In a lift coming downwards, your weight decreases. And if the lift is going upwards and accelerating, your weight would increase. Now suppose that lift is in a state of free fall and you are sitting inside the lift, then the acceleration it would be undergoing will become equal to acceleration due to gravity, and therefore the pseudo force acting on you will be equal to the product of your mass and acceleration due to gravity. Hence the net force acting on you will become equal to mg minus mg, which is zero. So you will be in a state of weightlessness. You will literally be able to fly inside the lift and tell your friends about the flight if you survive the crash. And last thing about the lift case is that you saw I gave the example of lift separate from the other examples. Of course, first reason was because I introduced the concept of pseudo force, but the second and more important reason was because in case of lift, acceleration was effective, but it did not change because of a change in the factors it depend upon. It did not change because of a change in distance. It changed because of the sheer fact that acceleration is a vector quantity, and being a vector quantity, it follows the laws of vector addition. So if there was an acceleration A0 countering g, then the net acceleration came out to be g minus A0, which is surely less than g. Hence, your weight, or the apparent weight as we should say, came out to be less than your actual weight.
Just like in the lift, your weight decreases in many other situations too. For example, astronauts in ISS, you flying in a plane, you being a passenger in a plane, your weight decreases. And you do feel those tickles going up your stomach when the plane is about to land. Well, that's the pseudo force, or G-force as they famously call it.
Guys, for watching this video. This was my longest video and I took some time to make it, not because it was long, but because I was busy in a shifting process. So thanks once again. If you like it, click on the red button on the top and subscribe to my channel. If not, I'm Udit, disengaging today.